Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Short Stories of Imam Sultan Muhammad Shah. One Ismaili of Tuliar, a village in Madagascar, had a problem of hearing since childhood. In 1954, he became virtually deaf. He referred to his case to several doctors, but none could cure him. He came in Paris at the end of 1954 in order to seek guidance of Imam Sultan Muhammad Shah. He explained his case to the Imam, who graciously recommended him consultation of a certain specialist and also said, in case the specialist may propose its surgery, you don't do it and come to me. The specialist examined his ears and said, it needs an operation. If you undergo it now, there is chance of 50% success. I have done many successful operations of such cases. Don't scare on my advice. He said that he would refer it to his Imam and do what I am guided. He once again came to the Imam, who said, don't undergo operation till 12 years. You come to Paris after 12 years and make operation from that specialist. You now go back to Madagascar. In 1966, he came in Paris and went to the clinic of that specialist, who was alive at that time. He examined and said, had you undergone an operation 12 years ago, it was possible that you have become completely deaf. Thus, his operation was done and its result was successful. Story 2. In 1954, Imam Sultan Muhammad Shah sent his two beloved grandsons in Madagascar. They were lodged in a nice bungalow of a rich Ismaili, about 8 miles away from Jamathana. Among the rich class, two persons came forward and offered their new cars for Prince Karim and Prince Amin. They came out from the bungalow and saw two cars ready for them. Prince Karim preferred one car which was parked at his front side. Both brothers sat in the car and Prince Karim himself drove it. The fortunate person whose car was chosen sat behind with the Mukhi. The car crossed about 4 miles, and yet 4 miles were to pass to reach the Jamathana. There was a turn on the road where was a big tree and the car collided with its trunk. The car stopped, but it sustained no injury to them. Mukhi came out at first and sought permission from Prince Karim. If you agree, I may go to the post office to make call to your grandfather to inform about the minor accident, making no damage. Prince Karim said, no need to make call to my grandfather, who is an Imam and knows that it hit nothing to us. My grandfather is present over here. Story 3. Dr. Wazir Pir Muhammad Hoodboy, the founder president of Ismailia Association for Pakistan, went to Europe with his wife for the treatment of heart trouble on 2nd June 1955. After medical examination, he desired to purchase his favorite cufflink and wandered from one to another store. He came back to Karachi on August 5, 1955, after having an audience with Imam Sultan Muhammad Shah. Prince Ali Khan had promised to see him at the airport of Nice. Wazir Dr. Hoodboy waited for a long time, but Prince Ali Khan was too late. There were few minutes in taking off of the plane. He issued the boarding cards and walked towards the lounge. He saw at once the coming of Prince Ali Khan, who regretted for being late, and presented a perfume bottle to Warasiani, Maryam Bai, and a small box to Wazir Dr. Hoodboy, a gift from the Imam for him. Both of them thanked and quickly got into the plane. Wazir Dr. Hoodboy opened the small box in the plane and became highly surprised to see in it his favorite cufflink.